Amir ate 2/3 of a piece of red licorice. So let's draw a piece of red licorice over here. And let's draw it into thirds. So or split it into thirds. Three equal sections, as best as I can draw that. And he ate 2/3 of it. So that's 1/3 right over here, and then this is a second third. So that's 2/3. What I shaded in, this is how much of that red licorice he would have eaten. Then they tell us Nico ate 2/3 of a longer but equally thick piece of red licorice. So it's gonna be equally thick, but it's longer. So I'm just gonna draw something that is longer. So that's longer, but equally thick. And he also ate 2/3 of this, but this is a longer piece. And it's equally thick, so it's actually gonna be just a larger piece. It's gonna have more licorice in it. So 2/3 of that, let me see if I can split this into thirds. And then this is 1/3, and this is a second third. Well, 2/3 of a larger piece is going to be more than 2/3 of a smaller piece. This right over here, this amount that he ate, it has the same width, but it's longer than this right over here. So Nico, because this is a longer but equally thick piece of red licorice, Nico ate more red licorice. Nico for sure. Let's do another one. My unicorn, that's interesting to have a unicorn. My unicorn ate 2/6 of a pizza from store A. All right. I ate 2/6 of a different pizza from store B. Who ate more pizza? Well, it depends. You know, store A's pizza might look like this. Store B's pizza might look like this. So if this was the case, so if this is store A and this is store B, you eat 2/6 of this. Let me divide this into 6. So that's halves. That would be, and then 6ths. Whoops, I don't want to do 8ths. I want to do 6ths. So I want to do something. So that's close enough. You get the idea. So 2/6 would be like this. 1/6, 2/6. And 2/6 of this would be like this. Let me do my best shot at drawing this. I'm trying to do 6 equal pieces. It's hard to hand draw, but this gets us close. 2/6 here would be that and that. And if so, store B's pizza is bigger than store A's pizza, then I would have eaten more pizza than my unicorn. But it might have been the other way around. Maybe store B's pizza is like this, and store A's pizza is like this. And if this was the case, if my unicorn ate this 2/6, then the unicorn ate more. Or maybe the pizzas were both this size, in which case we would have eaten the same amount. So just based on what they told us, we don't know how store B's pizza compares to store A's pizza. We don't know. We don't know whether I or my unicorn got more pizza. Let's do one more of these. These are fun. It took Hero 1/3 of an hour to run from his house to school. It took Fred 1/3 of an hour to run from his house to school. Who took more time running to school? Now this is a good one. This is a good one, because at first you might say, okay, you know, Hero might live here. That's Hero's house. I'll put H for Hero here. Maybe this is the school. I'll just try to draw a larger building right here. This is the school. And you might say, okay, well maybe Fred's house. Who knows where Fred's house is? Fred's house could be here. It could be there. It could be over here someplace. It could be over here someplace. We don't know where Fred's house is. We don't know if it's closer or further away than Hero's house. So you might be saying, oh, we don't know. But remember, they're not saying whose house is closer or further away, or even who ran faster. They're telling us who took more time running to school. And they directly tell us the amount of time they took. Hero took 1/3 of an hour to run to school, from his house to school, and Fred took exactly 1/3 of an hour. I don't know who ran faster or slower, or who went further distance or shorter distance, but I know that they both took the same amount of time. They both took 1/3 of an hour. So this is the same. They both took the same time. This question's a little bit like the famous brain teaser that some people might ask you. What weighs more, a pound of gold or what would you rather have? Or actually, no, what would, I know which one would you rather have. Which one weighs more, a pound of gold or a pound of cotton? And people are like, oh, gold is heavier than cotton. Maybe gold would weigh. But we're saying a pound of gold versus a pound of cotton. Well, they're both a pound. They would weigh the same. That's kind of what we're doing in this question right over here.